Alright guys, welcome to Paleo Brain Bird. Today is a special day. I've got some unique material that I'm working with. This is some green rhyolite that I got in a trade a while back. I apologize, I'm not even sure who I traded this with, but I believe it came out of New York. It is some tough stuff. You can see there's kind of a nasty pocket right there on the tip. Not sure if that's quartz or what it is, but that may be an issue, so we may need to knock that off. So we're going to start with the big bopper. Excuse me. I know we usually start with a smaller bopper, but I think in this case we're going to start with the bigger one. Do some trimming. Try and blast off that ridge on the front. Trying to get it in the shape. That was a pretty thin flake. Ugh. This stuff is tough. Got that flake off. That left me with a really big step. I'm gonna have to address that later. We might have to actually zigzag this. So let's just get it as thin as we can. Thick spot. I'm trying to zigzag, but we got to that really thick spot. Might need to take some. We're running right into a step. That's not a good thing. Oh, yeah. This one, too. So, if I try and blast off a thinning flake, I'm going right into the step. If I don't have a lot of power to undercut that, I'm in some big trouble. So let's see. Eek. Let's see what I got. Yeah. Did not undercut it. But that's okay. We can try and get it from this one side here. This is some tough stuff. lower this other edge, then maybe I can blast that step off from the other side. So even though this is a big rock, I am not expecting a big point. It's not easy to work with, so... So I've lowered this edge here. As you can see, it dives down. Not normally what we would want to see. But in this case, I want to get rid of that weird, big, thick island, funky spot. I'm not used to working with this stone, rhyolite. This is probably the second or third time I've actually worked with this, so the stone is a bit of an enigma. Oh man, that's nasty. If I can't blast it off, I'll just try and reduce the stone and get down to that area. Alright, let's just try and thin this stone down. There we go. I'm just trying to kind of work my way into that step. I have plenty of stone to work with. So I'd rather get an opportunity to take that step out, which, oof, man, that's not looking good. Eesh. Not looking good. All I can do is try and trim that edge to the point where that center line gets to a point where I can take off that step. Ugh. This is big and ugly. That did nothing. That was a good flake. Oh, look at that.
That's a nice flake that came off. We'll save that for another time. I'm going to switch to a smaller bopper just so I can get a little bit better accuracy. Looks pretty thick. I don't know if it's gonna go. Maybe I can try with some pressure. Pretty big and ugly. This is some tough stone, this rhyolite. Let's build it up to something a little bigger. No, not too big. This is the next size up. This rhyolite is really some tough stuff. Let me tell you. Thank you.
flake just does not want to come off. Let's try it again. Front base. Support. There we go. Something came, yeah, it wasn't enough, but it came off. I'm going to build it down. I know a lot of people would still stay the higher billet, but I think this gives me more control and allows me to kind of manipulate those sections that I need to manipulate. We'll see if that's right or not. Not great. But, gonna keep at it. This is some tough rhyolite, let me tell you. I mean, look, you can see big, giant islands here. I'm gonna do my best, see what I can do. One island that's in the way. I don't know if I should try and pressure flake that or just try and blast that off. I don't know.
trying to pressure flake it and see what happens. I'm gonna use this big point from Dave Tenbear's. I think it's aluminum. Let's go back to my trusty copper. This is going to be through percussion. I need to trim that down. And just blast it off. And once I blast that off, it'll be a nice little point. I just have to get to that point. No pun intended. Time just blasting off that edge. All I need to do is blast off that edge down here so I can lower the platform and blast off this piece here. So I'm just having a hard time doing that. Maybe I'll set one more flare. See if it helps. Try a bigger popper. I
break it, but I have to get that giant nub right there off. I mean, that thing is, it's ugly. It just has to go. Support the tip in the base, so I can uncheck. Coming off. Let's try and flake a little bit of it off. See if we can at least improve the situation. The problem is that if we don't improve the situation, it actually makes it worse because now there's less to pressure flake off of. Set up the other side. Tough one. Man, this stone is tough as nails. This is, most other stones, this would be not a problem, but this rhyolite is just tough as nails. I'm gonna hit it hard. It's probably gonna break it, but we'll see. This one is tough. That big spot right there is giving me a really hard time. Hope that I can get him out. This might be a long video. Belt down to see if I can kind of carve out a platform here, because I think what the problem is, I mean, it seems pretty good so far, but that one spot right there just does not want to cooperate. So let's see if I can make a smaller platform. This is taking forever. I apologize. This is probably going to be the worst video I've put out yet. But this Rhyolite is just some really nasty stuff. Just trying to put a platform together. See what I can get. Maple billet up. Try to bring a billet. See. Switch to the biggest billet of all. just to get a little bit off there. Nah, it's not going to work. So this is a conundrum.
So you see I have a decent preform here, but with that fat spot over there.
It's kind of hard to deal with. Not exactly sure how to blast that off. I have a solid copper bopper here, which is really heavy. I think what I need to do is address it from the other side first. There we go, I'm making some progress. About time. There we go. Wow, this was super long. Just gotta get this big clump right of here off, and then I'm good, but man, that's been tough. There we go. That's nice. Boy, that's going to be a lot of fast forward. That one spot was super tough. This is really sharp though. This is a nice, nice stone. And here we are. The base could use a little bit of thinning. Maybe we'll try that. break out the pressure flaker. Yeah, I can't find the other one, so I guess this is what we'll use. This is really cool because this is the first time I've worked, not the first time, but first time I've really given a good go for rhyolite, so pretty excited about these results. Yeah, call this a nice preform. Finish this off in the final steps. Trying to bring the center line up even as best I can. It certainly is not perfect, but Alright, check that out. This is a nice preform. It's not too bad. Needs a little bit of work, of course. That's why it's a preform. But this is some really cool stone. I got this from, I got this from Brandon Gilko. Maybe I got it from somewhere else. But this is Rhyolite from New York. And it is some nasty stuff to work, let me tell you. This was not easy. And I actually am pretty proud, pretty excited about my results. So, I hope everyone's having a fantastic day out there. Paleo Greenbird signing out. See you later.